Hello friends, today we are going to learn about the topic software as a service characteristics. What are they, how do they work, and why are they important in a software as a service environment? Software as a service characteristics. Today, software as a service, which is also called as on-demand software, has become an alternative choice for traditional standard softwares. Unlike traditional methods of buying and installing softwares, software as a service applications are sold on a subscription basis where the vendor is responsible for all hosting and maintenance services. It is ready-to-use solution for both the small and large business organizations because it just requires an internet connection to access the application through a network. It has become very common for organizations to use software as a service for their business processes without much worrying about complex software and hardware management. See, now here, all we know about software as a service is it is a software that is being used or applications that is being used on a rent basis or subscription basis. Say, for example, if I am accessing any of the application in software as a service model, I take an example of a Netflix. Now, I am paying for Netflix only for the subscription. And I am not responsible for anything. Now it is the responsibility of the vendor that whenever I want it, it should be there because I have subscribed for it and I can access that services there. It includes many applications for business purpose, from antivirus software to accounting and invoicing like ERP, CRM, DBMS software, etc. A good way to understand the software as a service model is by thinking of a bank, which protects the privacy of each customer while providing service that is reliable and secure on a massive scale. A bank's customer all use the same financial system and technology without worrying about anyone accessing their personal information without authorization. Since software as a service is the direction that business technology is growing today, it is important for everyone to understand its key characteristics. What are its key characteristics? The first one is multi-tenancy architecture. Multi-tenant architecture is very economical model to businesses because it allows multiple customers to share the development and maintenance costs. Then this model allows users to share same application instances but with different data and application design. Businesses can manage their activities from a central application location instead of making changes to each user instance. Here, what multi-tenancy architecture explains us is that, say for example, we have taken the example of Netflix. Now, I am not the only one who has the subscription to that particular application. Instead, there are several other who had the subscription of this application and they will be accessing that particular application at the same time when I might be accessing it. Also, it is not necessary that I am the only one who will be watching this particular show. Instead, there can be hundreds of others who will be watching that show at the same time when I am accessing it. Thus, in multi-tenant architecture, software as a service should provide that all of them should access it or all of them can access it at the same time, anywhere, anytime, on any of the platform. Also, a multi-tenant architecture in which all users and applications share a single common infrastructure and code base that is centrally maintained. Because software as a service vendor clients are all on the same infrastructure and code base, vendors can innovate more quickly and save the valuable development time previously spent on maintaining numerous versions of the outdated code. Now, another one is access from multiple network devices. It is the another characteristic of software as a service. So, since software as a service applications are network based, they allow applications access from multiple network devices. It helps businesses to have better management of application because multiple users from the same instance can share the data across network. Improved access to data from any networked devices while making it easier to manage privileges, monitor data use, and ensure everyone sees the same information at the same time. See, as we have taken the example of the Netflix, if I am accessing one of the show, then at the same time, everyone will be accessing that same information. Then another one is easy customization. Now, what do we have in easy customization? The ability for each user to easily customize applications to fit their business processes without affecting the common infrastructure. Because the way software as a service is architected, these customizations are unique to each company or user and are always preserved through upgrades. That means software as a service providers can make upgrades more often with less customer risk and much lower adoption cost. Another characteristics for software as a service is integration with larger applications. That means instead of being used as a standalone application, software as a service allow easy integration into other platforms, either as a software to larger applications or as a plugin to platform as a service. It can be customized to integrate into the existing system or can be added as a software to the new application development. Then software as a service harness the consumer web. What do it do? Anyone familiar with Amazon.com or MyYahoo will be familiar with the web interface of typical software as a service application. How? With the software as a service model, here you can customize with point and click ease, making weeks or months it takes to update traditional business software. It seems hopelessly old-fashioned. That means when we are working on the traditional systems, it will take months to create that same thing which is available with software as a service with point and click ease. Then another point is, or another characteristic is, scalability. It has higher scalability than standalone software and allows the system to have variable configurations for each set or group of users. Once the upgrade is rolled out of a set of users, it will be reflected to all that user infrastructure. And then the software as a service trends. Organizations are now developing software as a service integration platforms or SIPs for building additional software as a service applications. The consulting firm calls this third wave in software adoption. When software as a service moves beyond standalone software functionality to become a platform for mission-critical applications. Thank you.